All right, guys, in this video, we're going to talk about alfalfa and the value that it has for wildlife. And you might be thinking that corn and soybeans is the greatest thing since sliced bread, but don't overlook alfalfa. All right, guys, we're kneeling here in a freshly seeded and established alfalfa field. Alfalfa is a perennial crop, so this seeding is going to last 6 to 7 years if it's well maintained, from the fertilizing aspect to weed management. But as you can see, we have a fantastic germination of the alfalfa. That was done about 2.5 weeks ago. When it was seeded, threw in 50 pounds of wheat to kind of act as a nurse crop as it's getting established. But most important thing we want to talk about in the video is the fact that a lot of agricultural acres are in a typical corn, soybean type rotation, but alfalfa and its plant characteristics have a lot of benefit for wildlife. Many times we see alfalfa as one of the first things to green up coming out of winter. So it's an incredibly high protein source. As antlers are beginning to grow during that April timeframe in May, alfalfa is absolutely rocking. And then late in gestation for does, we've got another high protein food source available to increase lactation rates and development of fawns. So you like getting down into the weeds of things, it's really important to consider alfalfa. A lot of times it also is just characterized as a spring, summer, early fall crop. And that may be the case, but in a lot of times, or a lot of portions of the country, say mid-latitude and south, 9 months out of the year, alfalfa has benefit, foraging benefits. So that's a huge span of time that wildlife, both turkeys and deer, are attracted to alfalfa stands. But let's talk about what can happen in an alfalfa field during those other few months, let's say the cooler season. If you don't have standing grain or you know that option for late season forage, what I would recommend is on your last cutting of alfalfa, if it is being cut for hay, go in and broadcast things like wheat, oats, turnips, brassicas, and radishes. That's going to extend the attraction of this field on into months like November, December, and January. So essentially at that time frame, we have year-round forage in these given acres between having some fall annuals interseeded into the stand of alfalfa after your last cutting of alfalfa. Generally, a field of alfalfa each year is gonna produce 5,000 to 6,000 pounds of food for deer. You start throwing in those added bonus crops for the fall, you've extended the life of the field and the attraction from a hunting standpoint, but then further increase the amount of tonnage produced. So I love alfalfa. This field is on my personal place. It's about 2 acres in size, and I'm excited for what the next 6-7 years is gonna produce out of this field for wildlife. I love turkey hunting, and I love deer hunting. So to see this establishment already and the growth, we're off to a great start. So if you haven't considered alfalfa, be sure you do on your own property. A couple important things to note, if you are considering adding alfalfa to your property, is make sure you do your research on the variety of alfalfa that you do select. There are different varieties with different pest management, growth traits, or seasonality or latitude, considering some areas are much hotter than others for prolonged periods of time, or some need more winter hardiness if you're more in the northern states. So make sure you do some research on the variety that's gonna work best for you in your region and the browse pressure that you're probably going to experience in the plot. So do your research there. And also you may see back behind, there's Milo that has kind of restarted growing in the back. This was from an earlier seeding this year. I'm not worried about it one bit, but I just did want to make note that is Milo from a previous seeding earlier this year. So there's a little bit of that left over, but the base of this is really solid alfalfa as a start. And guys, again, wonderful crop. Don't overlook it. From a wildlife standpoint, try to incorporate this crop where is most applicable, but try and incorporate in a lot of properties across the country.